Over the past year, we've shown you the ins and outs of some crazy science, but have you ever wondered whose hands these are, or how these videos are made?
You're about to find out.
Hi, I'm Greg.
And I'm Mitch, and we're the creators of AsapSCIENCE, and we thought it'd be cool to give you guys a behind-the-scenes look at how we create the episodes, who we are, and what we do.
So instead of doing a draw my life, because we're always drawing our science videos, we're doing a real life my life. Hey, we put out a video asking you guys to give us questions, so we're gonna answer a few questions. We're gonna take you on a little behind the scenes of how our videos are made, and that's what we're gonna do today.
So the first question is, which country do you live in?
One, two, three.
Canada! What is your educational background?
So I went to the University of Guelph, where I took biological science and I minored in studio art. And then after that, I went to teacher's college, where I learned how to become a teacher at U of T, the University of Toronto. And for the last year, I've actually been in the UK teaching at the Folkestone Academy. Shout out!
I also went to the University of Guelph and had a biological science degree. And I am clearly less educated because that's where it ended for me. But then I worked in some labs and did
simple mind.
Yeah, simple mind.
Next question. What made you start the channel?
Well, we just thought YouTube was pretty cool, and we had seen some other, you know, educational channels out there that we thought were really effective, and we just sort of thought, like, we love science, we love explaining science to people. Why don't we start up this channel that's kind of like quick, accessible science, more specifically for people who didn't think they like science? We thought it'd be awesome to, you know, reach out to people who think science is boring or think science sucks or didn't get to go as far as we did to find out those really awesome things. Because when you're in high school, sometimes science can seem boring and they don't teach you the really awesome things.
I think one of the first thoughts we had is that we had lots of friends around us, and what we'd like to do, like, kind of when we were all hanging out, was explain to them specific science concepts that we knew in, like, a simple way that we thought they would engage them. That was one of our first light bulbs when we thought we should probably do this in a medium where more people can access it. So the next question is, how did you think of and make up the AsapSCIENCE logo?
So we had like a big old chart with like names related to science, and, you know, there was like a couple of them we wanted, and the YouTube channel was already
some
taken,
are
or
so
the Twitter name
bad.
Was,
yeah, but how?
There's like Ever Wonder, Quick Science.
No, Ever Wonder was good.
Yeah,
we almost did Ever Wonder.
So then eventually we were just like AsapSCIENCE, and we're fans of ASAP Rocky. We were like, that's a pretty sweet name, and like, as soon as possible science. That was cool. That kind of conveyed the message we wanted to get across.
But the S is not a dollar sign in ours.
Yeah, unfortunately, we're not making as much money as him. In terms of logo, if you watch our very, very first video, we didn't even have a logo. We just drew it out, the AsapSCIENCE name. And in my mind, I was like, you know, every time we're gonna change it up. So the second video, we ended up making this AsapSCIENCE logo. But then after that, we got a little bit lazy and then decided to just use that footage over, and then this ended up becoming our logo forever.
How do you choose your topics?
Well, when we first started, we had a list of stuff that we had come up before even starting the channel, stuff that we thought was cool from university or our friends had asked before, and so we just compiled a big list.
You are all approaching us through Facebook and Twitter and actually in the YouTube comments. So I do spend a lot of time reading all your Facebook comments and your YouTube comments. I have a list on my phone of 275 topics that are really, really genius that have been thought of by you. So that's something that we really appreciate. What is the process of making a video?
Why don't we just go show you? So this is our office space, our new office space.
Okay, so the first step is figuring out an idea. So sometimes it'll be based on breakthroughs in science that we find interesting or books we've read. Or what happens is a lot of the time we don't know everything. So we got a lot of great ideas from you, and we have to figure out what the answers are and how we're gonna actually create a video from the information. And that involves research. So the second step is doing research with books. A lot of the times online, using peer-reviewed journals and articles, and we like to use PubMed, Google Scholar, and websites that can get us to those types of information.
We've got lots of markers. We're in the business of markers. Sadly, I should have kept all the ones originally. I used to chuck them out after they started going dry, but they do. I usually just kind of set them up here, and I've got, you know, everything ready to go. So millions of whiteboard markers. I'll make a graveyard for them one day. Generally, once we have the script, I just come over here. We don't actually finalize the script until we're drawing. And so you've got the camera just pointing down on the whiteboard, and you can just draw.
So even though Mitch has been drawing on a whiteboard a lot this year, originally we had the idea of sort of animations and explaining science through art, because actually I'm an artist, and a lot of the time I would like to blend science and art together. So these are paintings that I created of proteins. They're visual depictions of proteins through a software called Pymol. They're very delicate, intricate images, so I used them and then I painted them on a canvas using oil paint. And lastly, this is Bjork, who's a huge inspiration for us. She blends art and science in a very special way that we really look up to.
So here is our fancy state-of-the-art recording studio. As you can see, all the things you need, clothes on the left, towels and blankets on the right. I basically set it up with blankets and stuff. Just to like pad the noise, right? Because you want to have like a room where there's not a lot of echo, so you can just kind of get dry vocals. Dreams are an amazing phenomenon, and considering you spend roughly 6 years of your life dreaming, it's quite curious that we often brush them aside to be quickly forgotten. But what are dreams? And like the many science fiction stories or movies, could we ever record and figure out what we're seeing while we're dreaming? So basically, you bring the footage, so we have tons of different clips from the video, and we have different, like an audio that I've now edited, and so I have to match up the video footage with the recorded audio. So it's not the other way around. Some people think I talk to the video footage, but instead we like record one audio track and then I come and take the video and sort of like stream it all together, the different clips, to add up to the timing of the video. So the last step is to add the music. Usually we use the original song that I wrote, but every now and then I feel like, you know, writing a new song or adding a new jingle that suits that video perfectly. So I'm a musician and I have a music background. You can check out my own stuff at mitchellmoffitt.com to listen to my own music there. But it was just a nice way to incorporate my own interests into the videos and have music and science kind of collaborate on the ASAP Science channel. So what are your jobs outside of ASAP Science? I've always wanted to know.
Well, I just completed a year of teaching abroad in the UK in a place called Folkestone where I taught science. It was a really amazing experience. I got to actually do practicals and experiments and engage with the classroom really well. As well as on the side, I would go home and help with this YouTube channel and engage millions of people.
A year ago, we didn't really know that that could be a job, right? Like you just kind of start for fun and then it picks up. Now it's both of our full-time
both
jobs.
Both of our full-time jobs, yeah. Are you planning on collaborating with SciShow, Vsauce, Minute Physics, or any other science-related channel?
Yeah, we'd love to, totally. I mean, we had the chance to sort of collaborate with Vsauce 3, Jake, and hopefully we'll get to do that again. And we also just got to collaborate with Bill Nye, our like dream come true, which was really cool. Did you fight over who got to narrate the videos?
No. His voice is a lot better than mine. I narrated two of them, and it's true, I sound like the honey badger.
Ever wonder why both coffee and alcohol have the unfortunate tendency to make you pee?
Reveal one of your biggest secrets.
Oh my god, I can't think of any that are appropriate.
Yeah, you don't have any secrets.
Please sing for us in that voice, Mitchell. That would be so damn awesome. Floor is yours.
Like the periodic table song?
Or like Whitney Houston?
No.
Where did you learn how to draw?
I didn't really, like Greg's actually has an art degree, and then, but he was in a different country, so I had to start drawing and was like drawing. So I would just kind of, you know, look up different images of cartoons and try and figure it out and tried to make it as simple as possible, which added to our aesthetic.
Everyone says, oh, I can't do art. Anyone can do art. It's about practice and it's about teaching yourself and it's about just making sure you figure out the craft.
What is your favorite movie?
2001, A Space Odyssey by Stanley Kubrick. For reasons that we all know. What is your favorite video game?
Zelda. It's the best video game ever made. I'm obsessed with it. I've played every Zelda game and it's awesome. So, does the research of your videos ever change your lives?
Yes, I think it does. So, for example, after we did the scientific power of naps, we are power nap gurus now. In fact, I have power naps every day and I always make sure they're less than 20 minutes and I honestly think it does help. Mm-hmm. Coffee and alcohol. Consume those a lot.
Yeah, hangover cure.
Pee a lot. Hangover cure.
And stuff like productivity, you know, you learn about it and then you're like, or procrastination, you're like, I can't procrastinate now. I just told like a million people to stop procrastinating. So definitely.
And there's tips. A lot of the videos we have tips and we give examples of things you should do and it's a lot easier to follow them now. I mean, we're learning when we're making these videos, just in the same way that you're learning when you watch them, and it definitely affects our lives. Hopefully in the same way that they affect yours as well.
Thanks for watching this special episode of ASAP Science.
And if you want to follow us on Instagram or Twitter, personally, the links will be in the description below.
As always, got a burning question? Ask it in the comments or on Facebook and Twitter.
And subscribe for more weekly science videos.